Hello everyone, this video is being recorded on 20th April 2020, few hours after the Telangana government has resolved asking the private colleges and schools not to take or increase their fees for the next academic year. They also urged the private colleges and schools to take the fees on a monthly basis and not on quarterly or semi-annually basis. But today's topic is something different. I'm not going to talk about that. I really appreciate the Telangana government for that decision. And I appreciate Mr. KCR sir on taking that decision. I stand with it. I stand with him. Today I'm going to talk about a little different thing. Dear government, today I would like to take this opportunity and privilege to speak on behalf of all the students who are residing over in India. Well, I would like to bring to your kind notice that a lot of people in India, a lot of students in India are receiving a lot of calls and messages from the educational institutions asking them to pay their academic fees of 2019 to 2020. During a crisis like this, I neither understand how they are asking us nor how we are supposed to pay them off. It is really pathetic to see these kind of situations being happening in India and especially in our states. Had we used their college property or faculty, we would have paid them happily after the completion of the lockdown. But I think we neither used their property nor received any kind of educational content in return amid lockdown period. I was told that only 70% of the syllabus has been completed so far till March mid-2020. And I was also told that the remaining syllabus will be completed via online. The majority of the students in India are from rural and semi-urban areas. Now I am wondering if they even have a proper internet connection to receive uninterrupted and quality piece of education. Well, moreover, due to the technical issues and practical issues as well with the connectivity, majority of the students and lecturers haven't tuned to the online teaching and learning yet. Each and every individual in the world, including businessmen, politicians, firms, government agencies, only tend to invest in majority of the things that gives them profits in returns. So do we, sir. Even we are not any different. So my question to the government is, why do we need to pay for the things that we didn't use or didn't get benefited in return? Why do we have to pay for the entire academic year when the college and schools are functioned for only the 70% of the entire academic year of 2019 and 2020? We were not absent to pay the fees to any kind of educational institutions. We were in lockdown. We are in lockdown. In fact, the whole country is under lockdown. We are neither rich nor have any business organizations to pay their salaries. We are students who are aspiring to reach our goals. Our intention is not to skip or escape from paying. We would like to pay them. In fact, we have been paying them for ages, but we'd like to pay them, but only the truncated fees for which we were taught so far in this academic year 2019-2020. We were only taught 70% of the syllabus till mid-March 2020, and we would like to pay only for that. I heard that education was free earlier, but today, whether if you agree it or not, it is a pure business. My apologies if I hurt anyone's feelings by calling it as business, but it is the bitter truth in today's generation. Education is not a business, it is our right. If the government didn't take the required actions, sooner or later, education becomes only a privilege. Taking into account of all the poor and middle class families, my plea to the government is, please ask these education institutions to at least show some humanity and solidarity, at least in these kind of situations. Please take some actions against these education institutions. And please urge and pass an order in favor of the students, urging us to only pay for the truncated syllabus that we are taught so far in this academic year, that is 2019 to 2020. And if someone has paid the entire fee at once, I think their fees, their remaining fees, need to be redacted to the next academic year, that is 2022-2021. I think the same should be applied with the hostels as well, because everyone got confined to their homes. And please urge the hostels not to collect any kind of fees amid lockdown period. Government, please take the required actions as soon as possible. Your support in this discussion will be greatly appreciated. If this is implemented, then this will bring a huge relief and smile on the faces of the poor and middle class families. Thanks for taking out of your time, out of your valuable time, just to listen to this video. I have, whatever I just told now, I have written everything and posted on Twitter, tagging some of the government officials. Make sure to go there, retweet it so that it reaches maximum number of people and brings awareness among the people. Thank you.